Now, about your punishment.
Punishment?
That's right, punishment for staying on an assignment after specific orders not to.
Steve, I had to prove that Colonel Decker lied about me, and you know it.
Colonel Decker is now Private Decker. As far as your punishment is concerned, I'm sorry, Diana, but I'm going to have to insist. That you take a real vacation. Plane tickets, hotel reservations, and specific orders to have the time of your life.
Steve, I don't want to go.
Go.
Well, there's no suntan lotion in here, and I burn very badly. I don't have anything to read.
No books.
No books. No film for my camera. Cute. Well, you want to go with me?
I've actually sung this karaoke.
Okay.
So this will be the best one you get.
I can't do it right. I don't know this song like that.
Dude, any Gen Xer can sing that song.
Ready?
Won't you come see about me?
I'll be alone, dancing, you know it, baby. Tell me your troubles and doubts.
Giving everything
inside and out.
Love's strange, so real in the dark.
Think of the tender things that we were working on.
Slow change may pull us apart. When the light gets into your heart, baby,
don't you?
After today, you never know, you know? So a lot of things to think about, so stay tuned.
Forget about me.
I did the very best I could.
Ah, forget about it.
Don't
you?
You forget about me.
So much fun, quite the challenge, but one I'm never going to forget. So, thank you, Masked Singer.
Will you recognize
me? Will you recognize me?
Call my name, oh, walk on by.
Rain keeps falling,
rain keeps falling.
No.
As you walk on by.
Is that the right spot for that?
Yeah. That's it. What you just got is all you get.
Bye, everybody.
Hello, everyone. And you're here for SOT Productions Gaming here. So, the coin you just saw was the one that I had for October 31st of last year when I put that video on Halloween. No one remembers today that I put that on my video game walkthrough of Batman Arkham Origins. Now I'm doing it again for my next video game walkthrough. I'm going to do the B11 version of Batman the Total Series. But this time, it won't have any errors. And we'll see how well we can do if we have the adjustment settings right. Right. So, anyway, since Saturday is on March 10th. So, how can we mix it both together if you had Hannah Montana on Sensitarity? Well, I got a shorter version of the Season 4 intro bro, right here on SOT Productions Gaming. I hope you like it as we do Batman Telltale.
You get the best of both worlds. Chill it out, take it slow, then you rock out the show. You get the best of both worlds. Mix it all together and you know that it's the best of both.
Alright, we got everything under control. Batman the Telltale Series is now coming again to SOT Productions Gaming for 11th time. And in favor of this Sunday. On Sunday, February 18th, the Daytona 500 will be on Fox again. And guess what? Miss America is going to be at the Daytona 500. So you'll see a bunch of various Miss America references throughout the series. And you'll know what I mean. Okay. Hey. So, it's time to play Batman Toto. Let's start the series up now. This game series adapts the choices you make, the story's tailored by how you play. Alright, let's get the story started. Allow me. Okay. Gotham City. A dark, damp, night place. Home. City Hall at 8:30 p.m. One night there was about to be a break-in. And then someone came in. Shot a security guard. Hey!
What
the heck are you?
That's only two games in the car.
Be out of here before anyone can stop us.
Out.
know you're trying to create a myth, but be careful you don't turn into a monster. Sometimes you need a monster.
Come back! Come on! Come on!
Teach you to knock. Behind you, big boy.
You're succeeding. Criminals are becoming afraid of you, so are the police.
It's a scare tactic, Al. Just a performance.
Without a scratch.
So far. Doesn't belong to you.
I was wondering if we'd cross paths.
You broke the law. Here I am.
Cut the shit. The law. Don't tell me that's why you do all this. Squeeze into a suit, tie on a cape. Most people dressed up like that end up in Arkham.
I do this for the thrill of it.
I'll show you a thrill. Gotta admit it, though. You give a good chase. One day you might actually catch me.
Tonight.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
Then let's put you in a cage.
Bring it, Bat.
Right. Lollipop!
Right.
go to all that trouble for this?
Shit!
A myth can't be killed. You, however, are flesh and blood.
God damn it!
I said don't shoot!
Sorry.
No! Wait!
Catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Who put you up to this? Answer me or I let go.
But you won't. You're not that kind of guy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let go!
Level up, level up.
Finally, put your foot down. Together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would. Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Welcome to Wayne Manor, everyone. My apologies for the late arrival.
Oh, not to worry, Mr. Wayne. We've all made ourselves very comfortable. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you?
I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle, so the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Just wanted to make an entrance.
Congratulations, you almost missed it. You are a pillar of this city and my campaign. I need you here, tuxedoed and shaking hands. No one came here tonight to see me. I want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent." We're the grease, they're the wheels. And they're rolling in enough cash and votes to help make Gotham a place for families again.
I'll do anything for Gotham. It's my home.
It's our home. This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign. And now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those. It always makes me sound like a used car salesman. Which, for the record, I have not been since before law school.
All right. How about, our hope is in Harvey.
Look at you. That's not half bad. I'm gonna use that. Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, hmm? Come on. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to
Bob and Regina Zellerbaugh. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, thank you. But we're all here tonight because we want to make a difference. And that's what it's going to take. Every single one of us. Not just me, not just Mr. Dent. Everyone.
Right. Of course.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbachs are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Kate Bat freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman, or whatever it's called.
I'd say it all depends on the man. Sometimes you need a person who will go off script.
Such as dressing up in a bat costume?
And taking out the criminals who ruin our city. Though the cape may be a bit much.
And don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. With Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible. Truly terrible.
Tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... Well, I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, thank you. I wish my parents could be here speaking with you too.
And thank you, Bruce, for investing in the health of this city's future.
You have our support, Mr. Dent. Go get him.
We're on our way. Wow. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Well, hello. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
No, no, it's all right. You can stay.
Thanks.
Bruce?
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now, so formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Well, I'm doing better now that you're here. Well, I'll tell you, if all these stuffed shirts weren't around, I'd give you the private tour.
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Oh, this? No, it's nothing. Just, cut myself shaving.
What? Butler didn't help you this time? Hey, kidding. Kidding.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but, another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything, except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. At least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
I don't like this, Harv, but I'm trusting you.
Thank you, Bruce. Seriously. You know I have to pull every string I can to get elected.
Yeah, well, just make sure this one doesn't hang.
Word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
Let's talk privately, shall we?
Hey, I like this guy. Ready to do business before we even introduce ourselves. But we'll get to that. Carmine Falcone, thank you for welcoming me at your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Bruce Wayne.
I know who you are. The guy is gonna sell me his house.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone. My analysts say we're raising triple with Mayor Hill. Hey, what's...
Private audience.
Come on, guys. Bruce?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes. Have a drink, have a talk. I'll bring Bruce back to you soon.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say?
And you want to get in there and start to ask our time for Daytona by Harry? I want to do it, you want to see it. We're running out of time. Right. There goes.
Mr. District Attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will. The man talks too much, traps my face with words.
Unlike most people I've met, Harvey actually has integrity. He's trying to make Gotham a better place.
So am I. So are you. Hey, we all carry the city on our broken backs. Might lighten the load if we do so together.
I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne.
Chinwag?
Gives me indigestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me. Be a pal. I can get Harvey the mayor's seat. Or I can pull it out from under.
Oops. Sorry about that.
Whatever happened to being a gracious host?
Gracious host.
Okay, imagine. This is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. I make them all move. And I want to keep everything moving if Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home. Hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light. If need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city. Now, we got a good thing going, so I don't see why we shouldn't team up.
Oh, I'm everyone's friend.
Which means you really know us. Pick a lane before you have a head-on collision. You listen to me, kid. I know somewhere inside that tuxedo you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Whatever you say.
You're a good kid. You look like him, you know? It's nice that we understand each other.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Hey, I appreciate the hospitality, Mr. Wayne. But I don't think I'll put an offer on the house. A nice guy like you should have a nice place to live. I'll be seeing you, Bruce, while this city's still standing.
After the party was over, Bruce headed towards the Batcave. Well, here we are. We keep word on the duel, too. We'll be ready to know who it is.
It's me. She was really after it.
galactic fire will not end. Crews have given up trying to combat the blaze at the Otisburg processing system, owned by Ace Chemical. Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at them. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek the immediate district if you happen to breathe in any of that tar black smoke.
Lobster's murder caused quite a headache for commuters this morning. The body of Falcone family capo, Rui Pistachio Falcone, was found hanging off the side of the 4th Street Bridge sometime just before dawn, causing traffic to back up for miles as the cops cut him down.
Holographic lenses? Voice modulation? Wayne Enterprises really outdid themselves with this version. Addition. Can program it to reveal trace elements in a confined space. Can deliver a jolt or knock out electricity in the area. I suppose that Catwoman would have preferred the latter. Spare grapple.
Can't believe he learned to do that.
Well, the test run at the mayor's office was a success. Should see if I can refine the edge. Could be sharper. My suit absorbed most of the damage from that gunshot. I've got to protect my back, even from the police. Should be able to read whatever data is on that storm drive.
Find out what was so important.
encrypted.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here. In a dark, damp cave. In front of a computer.
I'm more at home here than the rest of the house, you know that.
Then we should build an 8th bedroom down here.
Sure, I can see the headlines now. Bruce Wayne, billionaire, entrepreneur, cave dweller.
Quite an eclectic resume. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
In the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle. This is a map of the Eastside shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone.
I would have been tempted to be far less polite. I'd recommend leaving the fist fights to your alter ego. Bloodstains are much harder to remove from a tuxedo.
I had everything under control.
It's true. I've seen you take down worse thugs. But I'd already sewn you up once tonight, and I had no interest in a repeat performance. For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
Never seen her before. Hopefully she's just a tourist. No, I already checked the codex.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
That's not the point. I want criminals to know I'm out there. Batman isn't hiding from anybody.
I was talking about Bruce. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I have a job to do. Okay, a responsibility to this city. You know why I do this.
For the car, I presume.
Well, the car helps.
Oh, yes, you drive that thing like a bat out of hell.
Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse.
One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. What? 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but... his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now? Haven't the faintest idea.
I think he just wants to reconnect. Criminal record or not, he's
round and round.
If I heard the correct
round and round.
Young monster,
trouble, host. Advice to be cautious.
I know you're not.
where are you, Oz? Thank you, sir. Statue, but no Oz. Well, that isn't what it used to be.
Hey.
Beat it.
Leave me alone. Leave you alone. Right. Did you say beat it or leave you alone? A lot more graffiti. And of course there's a statue. Oh, it's Oz.
Watch wallet cash.
But this is goes through you.
Hey, you heard it, man.
The hell are you waiting for?
Huh?
Sorry, fellas. I've got nothing.
End him!
Oh boy. Here comes Oswald.
Gentlemen!
Oz.
Keep walking, alright?
This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do.
And you're... The moment!
Oh.
Come here! Come here. Think that'll do!
My cars and red underwear are coming too. Right. Right.
Stay down!
Ooh, that was close. Here goes the my cars and red underwear. In fact, I'm in the demo. Get the
guy in
the
ring!
Oh, didn't see the
Lindacar smile. Seems to be a nice place for
oh.
You. No love's like you'd open door.
Oh, boy. Didn't see the
Lindacar
heart, and didn't see the
Bramley
coming.
This is my park! Mine! You hear that?
Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, There. Good as new.
Woo! That was a right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
Thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
That's very thoughtful of you.
It's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you in, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mum and Dad, they put so much work in here. Glad they never saw it like this.
It's a shame what happened. It was beautiful once.
And now, it's a hellhole. Last thing my parents ever built. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, Odin. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know.
I don't want it to be a hybrid only, but I still want it to be part hybrid and part
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we do. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential. Now all I got is this park.
Well, that's just the way it goes sometimes. It's out of our control.
Well, obviously, but you don't have to be a dick about it.
Are you talking about that?
Good to know you haven't seen this, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home! That oily... Wish I could have punched that grin in the back of his throat.
It's politics, Oz. That's how the game is played.
I thought you had more integrity than that. Falcone made a stack of cash in corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And... it'd be a treat to watch him at pavement. Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are going to be on the upswing soon, though. A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down.
Good morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars?
I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. Oh, we didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. Worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. And Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
My parents loved Gotham. They invested their blood, sweat, and tears in this city. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, my hope is in Harvey to make sure a night like that never happens again.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
I say we leave the asylum standing as a reminder that we can do better. This time we won't fail those who need us most. All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You even shook his hand.
Harvey is the one who invited him. Personally, I would never welcome that man into my home. Anyone else have a question?
Please keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
And did anyone else receive this evidence?
The Globe, the Gazette, we all did. Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What are you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
I think you should check your source. Sounds to me like an intern is finally putting their creative writing minor to good use.
Mr. Wayne! Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What are you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. Where the hell it's coming from? Damage controls my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Right. Of course. The manor. Of course. Could have known that.
Mm-hmm.
The police are there.
Hey, hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
There's gotta be a mistake.
That's what we're here to find out. Maybe we made a mistake. Maybe you did.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive. Need to be the guy doing your taxes.
And what do you expect to find?
It's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve. Mayor Hill signed up on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Okay, so you just do whatever Mayor Hill says.
Hill and I, we have a vested interest to keep things professional. For Gotham's sake. Doesn't mean I like the words whistling through his windpipes. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's chopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us.
Yeah.
For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Nothing to hide. Oh boy.
I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
It's not a problem, really.
Oh, Bruce. First the mayor's office, now Wayne Manor. Gotham continues its streak of break-ins.
Yeah, really going for the record, huh?
Listen, Bruce. A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
What's your angle?
Not all reporters just want a headline. Some of us are old-fashioned. I still want the truth. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Carmine Falcone wants me to be in his pocket. He crashed Harvey's fundraiser and pretty much said, hop in.
Well, maybe he thinks putting a little fear in you will make you jump.
It won't.
By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood?
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vera.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family... We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this... on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
And we will. It's time to find out why. So late at the Cafe Tristy. Harvey looked at it. And
what the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning? That press conference turned into a bloodbath.
I'm in a lot of trouble, Harvey. And I need your help to get me out of it.
Yes, of course. Of course, whatever I can do. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah. Then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this. I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it. He has no right to issue search warrants without my okay.
You owe me an explanation.
And I will get you one. Straight from Mayor Hill's mouth. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
It's gotta be politically motivated. Hill can't match your fundraising, so he's trying to take out your biggest donor.
I don't know. This is a new low, even for Hill. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
We need to fight back. Hill cannot get away with this.
It may not be a war we can win.
The city will be behind you, Harvey, just like I am.
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being late.
No, just glad you made it.
You didn't tell me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selina.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Just election nonsense. I think we both welcome a change of topic.
I'm Bruce Wayne.
So you are.
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, sorry.
Selina's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can... drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
So, Miss Kyle, what brings you to Gotham?
Business.
Let's just hope she stays after what happened last night.
I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
Well, I sure hope whatever he took wasn't too valuable.
Actually, it was.
It's probably long gone by now, whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Ooh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. And things like this happen in my line of work. People tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye.
So, what do you do for a living?
It's complicated. High risk, high reward.
Ah, stock market, huh?
Something like that. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
It's quiet.
the sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
I will.
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
Yep.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good lord. Who could have done such a thing?
That's what I'm gonna find out. Gordon, Eastside Docks, Warehouse 133. It's a volatile chemical. Potential psychoactive nerve agent. Vile stuff.
Be very, very careful with that. Who knows what effects it may have.
Have the computer catalog the compound for further analysis.
As you wish.
Nothing left to bury. Exploded did so with enough force to obliterate the person standing next to it. But the chemicals themselves were inert, not explosive.
Well, it appears to have made a pretty big boom.
I'll see what I can piece back together. I've seen these outfits before. Same mercs that broke into City Hall. Looks like a bullet started this.
A normal bullet couldn't have caused that explosion.
This is a pure hole. The point of entry is melted.
Yeah, melted!
White Rose. Falcone's calling card.
He's been busy as of late.
Send the drones hunting. I want to know his every move.
Good thinking, sir.
Yeah. Good thinking, Alfred.
That bad?
Face slashed. Throat torn open.
So, not natural causes then.
Skylight Club.
Yeah. That's dope.
Blood. Broken nails. Bits of human flesh.
Yes.
This man's been badly burned. The damage seems to originate from inside his skull. Sensors say it's an incendiary round. Phosphorus residue. This could have superheated the contents of the canister,
causing the aforementioned boom.
Okay.
find a connection.
The bullet that killed the cop is the same type that blew up the canister.
Well, I'm sure they didn't find that at a local gun store.
It appears military. This murk to pieces, barehanded.
God, what would cause someone to do that?
The nerve agent could make them psychotic. Something was here when the explosion occurred. Someone drove off after the explosion.
Have you put it together?
Yes. Falcone leaving his rose here. This is a message. Dead cops, stolen chemicals. He's making a big move. The snipers hit a canister with an incendiary bullet, causing it to superheat and explode. This may have been a distraction or a way of destroying evidence. Cops moved in to stop the theft. Falcone's men got up there. Then things turned grim. Possibly due to the psychoactive nerve agent. A cop ripped up a merc's face with his bare hands. It was put down. Same sniper, same type of bullet. Looks like Falcone's men got what they wanted and escaped.
Have you located the shooter?
No, but based on two impact trajectories, the canister and a dead cop, the shooter could only have a clear shot from there, there, or there, and would have contaminated himself with a phosphorus residue. Program the skimmers to pick up that signature.
Right away, sir.
Both targets could have been shot from here, but no phosphorus trace. This is the right spot. So where did he go? Trace stops here.
Then he should be nearby.
Found him.
Time to go to work. To this graveyard. No, Cody, why did he do this?
I ain't telling you nothing! You can't make me talk!
You didn't do this alone. Where are the others?
Long gone.
Oh, really.
You won't find him!
And then the Batman puts on the handcuffs.
You trying to scare a confession out of me? I won't break.
Here comes the good part.
It's true what they said about you. You're a freaking animal.
Time to live up to my reputation. You know, you can bleed to death without ever spilling a drop. All on the inside. Tell me the plan, or I start swinging.
I ain't scared of you, man. Tell me! The Catwoman was supposed to hand over a drive. Had the container number we needed, but she flaked. So we had to find it ourselves. Container by container. Someone must have heard us. Called the cops. We were told no witnesses.
Why risk open war with the GCPD?
Some kind of chemicals. Falcone wanted them.
What are the chemicals for?
We were paid to steal and not ask questions.
I start here, and keep breaking until you answer.
The chemicals! Some kind of explosive! A weapon! I don't know! Falcone said he'd use them soon!
Used? Where?
That's all I know! I swear!
Alright, that's it.
You'll never hold a gun steady again.
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ. These are cops. Get an ambulance in here!
You're going to call the coroner instead. He's Montoya. Send the cleanup unit to the docks. Warehouse 133. Now put up your hands! Don't move!
Batman! What did you do to him?
Don't move!
He confessed to everything.
It's how you got it I'm worried about.
You have the right to remain silent.
Gordon.
I said silent! If you say another word, I will shoot you.
I don't care if half the city thinks you're a hero. Right now, you're a suspect.
Put down the gun, Detective. I'm on your side.
Oh yeah? It doesn't look like it.
It will when you hear what I have to say. Falcone stole a shipment of chemicals. Appears to be a weaponized nerve agent. Causes people to go berserk, turn violent. We need to act before he releases it.
I got a task force on it.
You already have one.
You're taking this too far, Bruce.
Alright. Back in the back cave.
You assume the persona of a bat, but you're not an animal. You nearly killed a man tonight. Your parents didn't raise you this way. And neither did I.
He's still alive, isn't he?
And in the hospital. Next time, it might be the morgue. Especially now, during this preposterous attack on your family, you must show the world the true nature of a Wayne.
Giving everything to the city and then being murdered for it?
My thoughts exactly. Every time you leave this cave. You're a good man, Bruce. Good. Just like your parents. Don't lose that.
I don't mean to be a doddering old fool on the subject, but as a friend, the burden of advice falls on me.
Who my parents were, the life they led, Gotham revered them. I could never match that.
You won't. You will far surpass them. You bury the person, Bruce, but you never bury the memory.
Sometimes I wish I could. That night, that alleyway. It made me who I am. I can't get it out of my head.
That is your gift and your curse. Being Batman can allow you to turn back the tide of treachery that's reached this city's shores, or drown you in its sorrow. When you doubt your fate, remember why you started all this. Remember that boy in the alley.
I won't forget.
Neither will I.
And there's the codex.
Well, back into the fray again.
Looks like that egg finally cracked. And inside, Mayor Hill was hiding more than I could have imagined. This is a complete manifest of Carmine Falcone's criminal organization.
What in the world was Hill doing with all this? Illegal arms dealing, drug running, mob hits, money laundering? Falcone's been involved in everything.
You see Dad's name on any of these documents?
I'll run a search, but so far I don't.
This is it, Alfred. With this proof, we can finally knock out Falcone's organization.
Where would we possibly begin to dismantle it?
This is a police matter.
There's only one cop we can trust to handle this evidence correctly.
Lieutenant Gordon. He could mobilize the entire police force against Falcone.
What about that reporter from the Gazette?
Vicky.
Yes, Ms. Vale. She could release this evidence through proper channels. I suppose it comes down to who you want to help most. Or who you think could do the most good.
Vicky showed faith in me. She cares about the truth. She'll get the story out the way it needs to be told.
A wise decision, sir. We'll attack Falcone on two fronts tonight. Vicky through the media, and Batman...
by any means necessary. Whatever Falcone is planning, it ends tonight.
He's Spider, Bruce. Eyes everywhere. A dense web of goons poised to trap you. No one has ever managed to bring him down.
I haven't tried yet.
Yeah. And then I see the play.
This is big. You drop a bomb like this, there's gonna be fallout.
That not even Falcone can survive.
Why give it to me, then? You don't know how much I appreciate it.
I need an ally in the press.
After handing me something like this, I'd say you got one for life. Falcone's slippery, but this is enough to hang him out to dry. What this could do for the city, my career, I'm just wondering what the cost is gonna be.
It'll be worth it.
I don't know, Bruce. Falcone doesn't like bad press. If I run this story, I put a price on my head. The next time my name appears in the media, it might be an obituary. Falcone has a way of handling reporters he doesn't like.
Buy a bulletproof vest. It's the dress code for reporters here.
Thanks for the tip, but I've held my own so far. I always think, crime in the city, it's a hydra. You cut off one criminal's head...
Three more appear in its place, I know.
Unless we kill the beast once and for all. But who's even capable of that? If we don't act fast, that void will be filled by someone far worse.
I backed Harvey's campaign for a reason. Fixing Gotham starts at the top.
Politics to the rescue?
For once, I think.
Doubtful. No matter how good-looking he is. It's a good thing you gave this to me instead of the police. Could end up buried in some evidence locker and not on every screen in Gotham where it belongs.
Public attention. That's what brings down men like Falcone. Not a bullet.
Though after my story runs, he might get that too. I'll be seeing you, Bruce.
It's done.
Good. So is our hunt. The drones located Falcone downtown, a place called the Skyline Club. Although you're not dressed for that kind of party.
Well, I can always change in the car.
Thank you.
intact.
I'm going in.
Very good, sir. Your turn to crash his party.
Time for a crazy train, Joe. Hey, bug. Knock, knock. Who's there? Crazy train. Crazy train who? Crazy train in your face.
Gotham's watching now!
Come on, Josh!
Give him a show! Help me walk! Whoa, wait! What are you?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I didn't hit mention because I was distracted with the game was that. That was a lot of terrible, big one.
Fire and smoke could reportedly be seen from street level. Tonight, the Skyline Club, a high-rise mafia hangout in downtown Gotham, was the arena for a clash between the notorious Batman and alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone, who was brutally wounded in the attack. Oh! Though I'd say the crime boss getting his is well overdue, Falcone has slipped through the law's grasp for years, but after this dramatic arrest and a stunning expose by Gazette reporter Vicky Vane, Falcone's going away for a long, long time. And speaking of newly uncovered criminal dealings, this brings me to the story everyone is talking about, the Wayne family. For generations, the big W on the Wayne Enterprises Tower was a reassuring sight. You knew that there was something pure at the heart of Gotham, that this city, for all its faults, was built by good people. But with Thomas and Martha's shining reputation called into question, we no longer have such assurances. And even worse, it seems the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree. Gotham's greatest son, Bruce Wayne, seen here shaking hands with Carmine Falcone, may be just as crooked as his parents. In his defense, Wayne fired back saying,
"Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood."
In a world where the Waynes, our golden family, are corrupt, who are we left with? Who can Gothamites look up to? The monster Batman? Only time will tell.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, we'll keep digging for the truth. But the common feeling throughout Gotham is that the Waynes' time in the sun is ending.
Entire cave.
Round and round.
Everything I built.
Round and round.
I didn't want any more innocent people to die. Then what the hell did we do this for?
Bruce.
What have you been hiding from me?
When your parents died, they left me as caretaker of their estate, their son, and their secrets. I would never betray them.
Never betray them, right. That's what will happen in the next episode Bound Total series.
Your parents were good people, Bruce. No matter what that thug Falcone told you.
And swear to me, there's no truth to it.
That scoop you brought me on Falcone helped me more than you could possibly know. I owe you.
This morning, the city woke up to photographs of just how far this Batman is willing to go.
Hell of a view!
Bruce, the Wayne name is toxic. I have to do what's best for my campaign. What's best for Gotham. I have to distance myself.
I will find the truth. Along with anyone who stands in my way.